Thank you, Professor Goel. Mr. Goel? Yes. We'll speak on city development, integrated and self-financed municipal solid waste management model for India. Great. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, friends. I'll be talking on city development, integrated and self-financed municipal solid waste management model for India. The introduction. This is the current waste management model. I have shown the waste processing units. You can call it landfill, you can call it dump. In practice, you may find one or two dumps or something like this. The objective study were neutralize the difficulties of current model, look for economic sustainability, look for environmental sustainability, try to integrate it with city development. The model should have a sustainable life cycle. The project risks should be sustainable. Accordingly, the waste classification is done. The waste is classified as soft bio waste, hard bio waste, vegetation waste, non-toxic waste, toxic waste. This classification is in alignment of how we are going to process it. The percentages shown are just to have an idea how many processing units will be required. The processing of waste, soft bio waste is processed with anaerobic digestions, hard waste by composting. Vegetation waste can be either processed with anaerobic digestions or composted. It is listed separately here because the process chain is different. Non-toxic waste will be filled in a micro landfill. Toxic waste is processed as per the norms. This is a key concept here. This is a micro landfill. I'll just explain it in detail with this as to what it is. As you see on the diagram, this micro landfill is a strip of 3 meters by 100 meters. It has a standard aggregate 0.3 meter width on either side. The central portion is filled with non-toxic waste to achieve a leveled surface. The waste is crushed and compacted as required. The stretch is now scientifically capped with pre-casted RCC slabs. While requisite load-bearing capacity, this strip can now be used as a road. So this 3 by 100 meter strip can be anywhere in the city. The micro landfill, as shown, can consume 120 ton of waste at density 2.5 and 0.2 meter average layer thickness of compacted mass. In the diagram, the earth surface is shown plain. In practice, it will be uneven, both length as well as width. The concept of micro landfill to process waste within city, convert it to utility road, is first the key concept of the derived model. It eliminates requirement of conventional landfill. These are the number of units which will be required in a city of 10 million population. Two things are to note here. All the units are micro level. The biogas plants are of 20 kg average capacity. The composting units are of 200 kg capacity per day, which will be just a small portion of municipal garden. The landfills required, or the micro landfills required, are 20 for a city with 10 million population, which is well within the norms requirements of the city. The responsibility starts with citizen. The citizen is either supposed to process the waste or drop it at a designated drop point. The designated drop point for soft bio waste is a municipal level, ward level biogas plant. The hard waste is dropped at municipal garden. Whatever other waste comes from the dealers of goods and services, it is returned back to the same dealers of goods and services on the next shopping. The vegetation waste is collected by ward officer and dropped at either municipal biogas plant or composting unit. Involvement of each and every citizen in waste disposal process is second key element of the derived model. The waste disposal responsibilities need some extra efforts on citizens' part, but the gains are phenomenal. The dealers, what do they do with their part of the waste? They either drop it at a transfer station or at a waste processing unit. Transfer station, all the non-toxic waste will be dropped. At waste processing units, the toxic waste will be dropped. What do the municipalities do? They have to specify the designated drop and maintain the ward level biogas plant, micro composting units, waste transfer stations and toxic waste processing units. What we see here is a switch to polluter pays principle. Now, what happened is the citizen is dropping the waste at their own cost. The toxic waste is processed at fee, and this will result in the savings to the municipality. Whatever municipality is spending on the waste responsibilities or the waste processing can be used for other civic amenities. The individual will pay or will incur the expenses in proportion to the waste generated by an individual. In the current model, I pay taxes, everybody is charged same irrespective of whether I generate 1 kg of waste, my neighbor may generate 10 kg of waste. When I incur the cost for dropping of the waste myself, if I am generating 1 kg waste, I incur the expenses accordingly. If my neighbor is generating 10 kg waste, my neighbor is incurring expenses accordingly. So it becomes with reference to how much waste you generate. Pollution pays principle regime is third key element of the derived model. It imparts sound economic sustainability to the model. A number of supports will be required. From the municipality side, we require support to create awareness. Public is key player in the proposed model. Adoption of biogas plant residential premises requires mass awareness. 1-ton biogas plant at ward level serves this purpose. It can act as nodal point to help citizen with operation and maintenance of micro biogas plants. Learn to children and learn through children can be another way to get to awareness. Children bags, water bottles, stationery, etc. can be green varieties which will make children conscious about environment issues. The school curriculum can have topics on environment. In addition, the municipalities will need to construct the micro landfills at the rate the waste is generated so that everything is cleared on day-to-day basis. The industry support will require in terms of the biogas plants of the required size, in terms of the burner, in terms of the control element for switcher of fuel, because in the kitchen, the biogas alone will not be sufficient. The housewives will be using biogas along with LPG. A case study. A simple case study was done on Indian dairy milk industry. India has a well-established dairy milk industry. Approximately 60 billion plastic bags are wasted annually. The milk supply chain has wholesaler, retailer, and delivery boy. This volume of plastic bags can be collected back easily. Consumers hand over the waste plastic bags to delivery boy hands over to retailer, and retailer hands over to wholesaler. The only requirement is change mindset a bit, and a bit of effort from consumer to the wholesaler. The waste bags can easily collected back during milk delivery schedule itself. The waste milk packets have recyclable value. The product is processed to produce material which is usable in road construction. Anywhere in the process chain, the waste bags can be sold to local waste dealer. This will generate some extra revenue. In current waste management model, most of the waste milk packets are part of municipal waste. A substantial part of it is littered on roads and streets, and a small but significant part finds path to animal stomachs as a result of roadside vegetation grazing. In derived model, the waste is reused. None of it is finding path to stomach of animals, and the process chain people benefit with some extra revenue. The benefits from one product, dairy milk itself, are significant. This will prevent the animals from pain and misery caused due to plastic deposit in belly. Similar results will be accruable from other packing materials also. Involvement of dealers of goods and services in waste management chain is fourth key element in the derived model. This promotes resource recovery. The derived model is, as seen, it is totally decentralized. The derived model is shown in diagram. The model is totally decentralized. Waste processing units are seamlessly integrated to city development. Waste processing units outside city process only toxic waste. Achievement of near total decentralization of waste processing units is fifth key element of the derived model. This minimizes the role of outsourced elements and imparts very high degree of robustness to the model. The compliance, it has got elements for self-motivated compliance. The model has inbuilt elements to achieve self-motivated public cooperation, decent returns on investment from microbiogas plants, well-maintained municipal gardens, and improved road infrastructure due to continuous requirement of micro landfills drives home the benefits of the RAI model to public. Public cooperation, self-motivation elements in the form of gains in day-to-day life is sixth key element of the RAI model. Everything will not be self-motivated, so we need some enforced compliance. Mass installation and operation of biogas plant at residential premises can be accelerated by incentives for a limited period. Use of rear vision cameras and RFID tags can be incorporated to detect violation. Stiff fines can be imposed for violators. Part of the fines imposed on violators can be paid back to the general public to encourage reporting of violations. Involvement of public to report violations helps in compliance monitoring at affordable administrative costs. The results, all redundant elements are eliminated. Conventional waste processing units process only toxic waste. All but toxic waste is converted to resource. Toxic waste composition is known and can be processed with available technical expertise. Integration of dealers of goods and services in waste drop responsibility promotes reduction, reuse and recycling of packing material, which otherwise is wasted after single use. The project risks involved are practically nil and limited to risks associated with toxic waste processing units. Use of mature and tested technologies for waste processing units imparts high success rate. The uncertainties associated with mega waste processing plants become past. The model has practically nil project risks. This is the seventh key element of the derived model. To evaluate the model, resource recovery is near ultimate. Total decentralization of waste processing units minimizes waste consumption of energy in waste transportation. Waste processing units are integrated to city. Conventional landfill is extinct. The model has practically infinite life cycle and is very high, has very high environment sustainability. The finances. Waste drop is by public at their own expenses. Microbiogas plants are financed by public. Ward level biogas plant repair the investment in 4 to 5 years. Composting costs offset by revenue generated from compost. The additional costs incurred on waste disposal in micro landfills are much less than savings on conventional landfill costs and associated expenditures. Toxic waste processing is charged to public. The model is self-financed and has very high economic sustainability. A food for further research. The micro landfill, as shown in the diagram earlier, is a theoretical concept. It is nowhere tested to best of my knowledge. It needs to be tested and tried with field trials, and maybe the parameters are modified or refined. To conclude, model is as high, well-defined logistics management. Resource recovery is near ultimate. The micro landfills are sustainable. The model has high environmental sustainability and is self-financed. The model is highly robust, as all redundant elements are eliminated. City expansion does not result in increase of waste disposal cost. The system life cycle is practically infinite. Composition of waste processed by toxic waste processing units is well defined, and it can be processed with optimal results as per available technology. Effective mass communication is most challenging and key parameter in the derived model. The model has capability to play a vital role in uniting and transforming the society for betterment. Long-lasting and sustainable results are feasible in a short time span with requisite dedication and sincerity from all stakeholders. Effective mass communication is the eighth, final, and most crucial key element in the derived model. The success of model is totally dependent on effective mass communication and willpower of executioners. This is the master key to neat and clean cities in future or continuation of current chaotic situation. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.